Shout out to all my inner lights out there for tuning into the star in you. It's Junus. Please subscribe, like the page, and share it with others. Hope all y'all doing y'all best out there and being blessed out there, sincerely. And definitely hope all y'all had a great 2019 as we approach the end. Today we're going to talk about the one and only, the queen of R&B itself, Miss Mary J. Blige. Let's get into it. Let's go. Mary J. Blige, she's born January 11, 1971. This makes her a Capricorn. She's an earth sign. The sign Capricorn begins on December 22nd and ends on January 20th. With Mary J. Blige being a Capricorn, she's going to be compatible with earth sign, which are Taurus and Virgos. She's also going to be compatible with water signs as well, which is Scorpios, Pisces, and Cancers. With Mary being a Capricorn, she's going to be ruled by the planet Saturn. And the planet Saturn is known as the oldest planet out of the zodiac signs, the father of Jupiter, actually. Though Jupiter is the king of all planets, you know, for its expansion and it being very ambitious, Saturn, at the end of it, rules it because it has that maturity and that discipline, that wisdom that Jupiter lacks at times for it being tactless. You know, with the planet Saturn ruling over Mary J. Blige, this is what she's going to show and possess within her traits. You know, with the planet ruling over her, she's going to shine for a lot of wisdom. You know, the native Capricorn have a lot of maturity, and this is something that we can learn from them. Because through the younger years, they go through a lot, you know. Even when they're born, they come out looking older, and as they get older, they look younger, like that Peter Pan syndrome thing. They come out with a lot of beauty, which you can definitely see with Mary J. Blige, how she walks the stages so gracefully, you know, over time, just shining and shining. So, with Capricorns, they stay upright and upbeat and up just and climb that mountain like the goat, you know, and persevere. This is what you're going to see. But through that coldness, climbing that mountain, though, they have that coldness, that aura, that just, it just comes with the territory. But however, though, with Capricorns, they wear it well, you know. Any room they step into, they just have that aura, that presence, you know, that genuine smile about them that's light up the room and keeps things very light, you know, if they're not judgmental, which they gotta watch out for. And, you know, this could be due to the fact, you know, if the planet Saturn itself, though it's the second largest planet, it's also one of the lightest elements within the universe. It could actually float on oceans. So this is something that you can see with Capricorns and why they could walk so gracefully even though they've been through a lot. You know, they still have that beauty that shines, you know, like the ring surrounding around them. So it's interesting to see. And, you know, speaking about the lightness of Saturn, Muhammad Ali himself, he's a Capricorn. And you see how he's lighting his feet, you know, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee, you know, type of dynamic. So you can see this planet, Saturn, how it rules Capricorn and brings this elegance within them. Her being a Capricorn, you know, she's going to be a cardinal sign, so it shows that she's a leader, she's an initiator, which is definitely evident in Mary J. Blige, you know. When she stepped foot in the scene of hip-hop, you know, showing her R&B skills, ever since then, it's been history, and you still see rock for it till today. So that longevity's there, the goat, the earth sign, showing that strength, climbing that mountain no matter what, like I was saying before. And it's kind of funny, so I'm thinking about the goat now, LL Cool J, he's always talking about himself being the greatest of all time, and he's a Capricorn. But, you know, that's just how Capricorns do it. They're, like, usually the first to do it, and they always do a style. And this is something you're going to see if Mary J. Blige, you know, step into the scenes. You know, when it comes to earth signs, they can be materialistic. They care about their presence. You know, they represent the physical world, but in a positive way. It's not materialism where they're going to be spendthrifts, especially Capricorns. You know, they're prudent, so they're very reserved, very mature, and they know how to spend their money wisely. You know, it's not like their brother Sagittarius, you know, could be generous and spendthrifters. When it comes to Capricorns, they're very protective of their bread, you know, for security purposes. However, though, they will spend their money on the right resources. And, you know, speaking about resources, the native Capricorn definitely has a lot of that. You know, they're very studious. So a person like Mary J. Blige, who's been in the game for a long time, anybody that's trying to look up to her for information, you know, she definitely provide a lot that she could actually put people through and guide them very intuitively, too, because, you know, she is born a master number 11, which we'll get to in a few. But with this native Capricorn nature, Capricorns like represent the physical world, so they like that one-on-one interaction, you know. Especially with Capricorns, though they may not be generous with spending bread, but they definitely will lend out their heart, you know what I'm saying? If somebody's like dying or sick in the family, they're probably gonna be the one that's right there in the bed rest, you know, till that person takes their last dying breath, you know. They're the type of person that's trying to provide. They're like the social workers, so they have that heart, you know. You gotta realize they're born the first month, and that one in itself is ruled by Leo, and Leo rules the heart. And this is why sometimes you'll see Capricorns and Leos get along very well. You see in family dynamics together. And you know, speaking about Leos and Capricorns, her ex-husband was a Leo actually, Kendu. And you know, they were together for over 14 years, so you seen there was some type of love there, some type of bond that was strong, though it ended wrongly, you know, poorly over whatever situation it may be. But however though, there's still gonna be a bond between Leos and Capricorns, though it didn't work out in their favor at that moment, you know, unfortunately. But you can see this with Barack Obama and Michelle Obama, with her being a Capricorn and him being a Leo. So you see there's a longevity, there's a tightness there because of that 8-in-1 dynamic coming together as a 9, that wholesomeness, that family bond, feeling warmth. And you know, though there's a separation between Mary and Kendu, all is not lost, only learned, of course. And with Mary being a Capricorn, something we could definitely learn with them is their resilience and how reserved they are. Because they care about themselves and they have self-confidence, which can come off as arrogant sometimes, but really just self-confidence. They work hard, they're diligent, they know how to utilize the right people for the right circumstances, but however though, they do work hard for what they get. So because of this, if they don't do like a breakup or something like that, you know, it won't be the end of them. It won't be their downfall, because they know what it means to be at the bottom and climb to the top. So with the native Capricorn, there's something mystical about them. They're not normally the type that's really into religion. They are into business though, you know, trying to make that bread. But when it comes to religion, sometimes they question it a lot. You know, they do have a high intellect. So sometimes they get more into the cult side of things, you know, the mystical side. And they hold that internally within them, especially being born that one frequency, that month, that one represent the magician. So they had that internally with them as they move intuitively. So Mary J. Blige, she's gonna learn to look within, you know, when she goes through these tough times. But internally, you know, she's gonna develop something new. She's gonna look for something happy to do, whether it be dancing or, you know, working out, looking for a new diet. But she's gonna incorporate that into her lifestyle. And over time, you're gonna see within her dynamics, like most Capricorn, they fit into like some type of new healthy lifestyle. They'll try to do something where they'll feel rejuvenated and youthful. And this is where they'll have that Benjamin Button syndrome. I said Peter Pan before, but I meant Benjamin Button syndrome. And this is where you see Capricorns develop over time. You know, they tend to look like they're in their 20s when they're like 50, 60 years old. So Mary J. Blige, you can see it now. You see how youthful she looks, you know, though she's like in her 40s. So it's a great gift when Capricorns are reserved and they do what they do respectfully. And you see what the universe gives in return. So it's very positive for Capricorns such as Mary J. Blige. You know, when they go through such breakups, they can be very resilient. They won't back down completely. You know, they'll feel... sometimes they can play victim and things like that, but overall though, they'll still survive it and still be accomplished and do what they gotta do and do it in a sophisticated manner overall, you know what I'm saying? You gotta notice with the native Capricorn, they can be very loyal, dedicated in a relationship and a marriage. They really do things with their hearts, so because of this in return, the universe grants them a reward too. For them to follow through, you know, when they go through tough times. And usually you'll see a Capricorn get involved in some type of activity that'll bring some type of youth out of them and keep them going strong. And you know, if Mary J. Blige, she does sing a lot about her pain, suffering, all throughout her songs, you know, she's known for that one. And you can definitely feel it powerfully. And this is because, you know, she's born with the master number 11. With that master number 11, when it breaks down to a 2. That 2 being ruled by the moon, the intuition, that water, nurturing, complementing her sun sign, which is Capricorn, going together. You know, the water coming in, the earth nourishing everything for everything to flourish. And she does this on her own with those ones. You see the 2-1, the Leo, that fixed energy. You know, complimenting a cardinal sign for her to move accordingly with confidence. You see, Mary J. Blige been in the game for a long time, you know, being represented for all the young ladies out there trying to do it today. So, you definitely want to look up to somebody, for example, it's definitely Mary J. Blige. With her having that 2 dynamic, you can feel that. But number 2 is something very melodic. People with this frequency are really fine-tuned to music. They got a great ear for it. And it's definitely ever, you know, a Method Man being born on March 2nd. And Mary J. Blige, that 11 frequency breaking down 2 and 2. And they created that wonderful track and that classic, All That I Need. So I guess it's evidence truth that 2 got the melodic thing to it. And you know, though Capricorns like Mary go through a lot, you know, during their lifetime, a lot of suffering. And with Mary, you hear it definitely through her songs. However, though, you also hear the vibration when she triumphs and she rises due to that master number frequency, number 11. You know, the 11 being ruled by the sun. Everything she sings about at the end, she's gonna try to turn it around where there's positivity at the end. There's some type of light. And you know, when it comes to the fans, you know, they'll say that her happiest songs are kind of like her worst songs, and the ones that she talks about when she's down or going through something real, That's like her real songs which they love the most. And that's because when you go to set the room and you triumph over it, that's where the real happiness really begins. So that's what you're gonna hear all the time, Mad J Blige, and the collection of music that she's brought to the table for so many years, you know what I'm saying? You know, the goat of R&B, you know, climbing that mountain of mastery, the master number 11, as you can see. Mary J. Blige, shout out to you, the queen of R&B. And shout out to all my inner lights out there for tuning to the star in you. It's Junis. We did it, y'all, for MJB, queen of R&B herself. Hope y'all enjoyed the content. Stay tuned for more. Be blessed out there. Do your best out there. And remember always, let your inner light shine.